relationship early. That's what this journey is all about. It's about our relationship with a holy God through his son, Jesus Christ. We need to have that relationship with him. We need to know him as Lord and Savior of our lives. Not that I'm just a friend of Jesus, but you need to know him personally.
Amen.
So if you're here today as the choir prepares to sing, and you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, will you come and let us pray with you? Yes. That he will come in and sup with you. Because he's knocking at the door. But he won't open it. You have to open it. He won't force himself on you, church. All you have to do is let him in. As the choir sings, will there be one?
We don't always come, amen, feeling like we need to be feeling, amen, feeling like we should be feeling. But it's some things that weigh you down.
Amen.
amen, weigh you down, amen. We dare not, amen, go out of here without, man, having, amen, an opportunity to come to the altar and lay it down for God, amen. Because we know, amen, sometimes even as Christians, amen, the weight gets heavy sometimes, amen. But we got enough anointing, amen, amen. There's enough anointing to break any of you, amen, that can try to bind you down. Amen, because I'm a believer, amen, regardless of how you come, amen, what's trying to hold you down, amen, and anoint you, praise the yoke, amen, we serve a God that's mighty, amen. So we, man, we just want to, amen, just have an altar break, amen, we just want to come, amen, and however God, amen, whatever it is that's holding you down, amen, and keeping you back, amen, we want to pray release on today, amen, because amen. It's all about being delivered, amen. It ain't about coming having a good time, amen, it ain't about us, amen, but if you weigh it down, amen, God want to take you somewhere, amen. He can't take you if it's too heavy for you to move, amen, because you're running out of energy, amen. God want to release all that stuff, amen. So before we go into brother, amen, we just want, amen, just lay it down at the altar, amen. We just want, amen, whatever it is, whatever your situation, whatever your circumstance, amen. We just believe in God, amen, that he's able to do anything but fail, amen. Because sometimes we can't tell nobody but God, amen. And that's the only person they need to know, amen. If you can turn it over to him, amen, I guarantee he can fix it, amen. We serve a God as a fixer, amen. We serve a God as a mind regulator, amen. Because we've been talking about all week that mind will mess you up, amen. Your mind sort of start getting to you, start thinking too much, amen. You can't even serve God like you need to serve him, amen, because you got so much mind clutter, amen. Today we're going to pray release, amen, on anything that may be holding you down, holding you back, amen. We believe in God. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name. Bless your name. Amen. We believe in God, amen. We serve a God that's able.
Thank you,
amen. We serve a God, amen, that this new weight that's too heavy, amen, and we should keep burdening ourselves with. Amen. It's all about release, amen. If you can't walk, amen, in the capacity that God has given you, amen, something's holding you back. Amen. Because we serve a God that's able. Amen. The troubles of life, amen, will come and try to set you back. The troubles of life will try to say, you know what, you just need to hold on a little bit. Amen. You're moving too fast. But we serve a God that he's not going to let you go, amen, comfortless. That's why Pastor was talking about. He said he went away, amen. But this time, at his amazing house, all during the week, the apostle last night, this was for real. God left us with something. He left us with something that enables us, that keeps us, that allows us, despite the circumstances, amen, to be able to get up. Right. He said, there's no evil that has beset you that is buried and not common to man. You ain't by yourself. A lot of times as Christians, we want to think we're the only one going through this. We're the only one that had this heartache. We're the only one that had these financial difficulties. Amen. We're the only one that had these family issues. Amen. The enemy know how to attack you when it hurts. And usually that's the family and the pocketbook. Amen. Those two things will get you, amen. Those things will keep your mind so bogged up, amen, you can't freely operate in Christ. Thank you, Jesus. But we serve a God saying that there's nothing too hard for our God. Woo, glory to God. There's nothing too hard for our God. Don't let family, amen, worry, because God got it under control. Amen. God has got it handled. But you can't talk it out, amen. God has already worked it out. Amen. You just can't see it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We serve an awesome God. God said, just walk in my power. God knows everything that you're going through.
To God be the glory.
God knew the heaviness of your heart before you came here today.
Amen.
Amen. God knew exactly, amen, what was about to take you over.
Hallelujah.
Amen. About to make you throw your hands up and say, God, I don't know no more. Amen. But he said, I did not forget who you were and how you have communicated with me. Thank you, Jesus.
This is the season
for miracles. This is the season for miracles. Too hard.
This is the
season. That you couldn't handle no more. So God said, I got this. I got this.
Hallelujah.
Woo. I know it's overwhelming.
My help
I know it's overwhelming. But God said, I got this.
My help.
I got this.
It's coming from God.
The help of the Lord. Bishop Pete last night, the help of the Lord. You can't do it yourself. Your mama can't do it for you. Your husband can't do it for you. Amen. You can't come in on that, but your help coming from the Lord.
This is the season.
Thank you, Jesus.
The miracles.
I believe, amen, that some minds are going to be free.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Some things are going to be laid down, amen, that you're going to say, you know, I ain't worrying about it no more. If God don't have it, it must not need to be handled. Amen. That's the mindset you gotta have. Amen. If God don't do this for me, he must not want it done. That's why Paul said, regardless of whatever state I'm in, amen, I'm still good. I had not. People talked about me. Some folks talk good about me. It didn't matter because I stayed in the same state.
Go ahead.
For consistency.
Go ahead.
Amen. God looking for consistency.
Yeah.
Amen. And in your consistency, in your pain and in your hurt and in your troubles, God said, I have not forgotten. Thank you, Jesus. I have not forgotten. I know it's hurting. You prayed about it, but you didn't see the results. The help coming from the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God saying it's trying to take you to that perception state. Amen. Perspective changes. Amen. You were looking at it in the wrong way. Instead of getting excited about it and giving God the glory because you know God about to take you somewhere. Amen. Mentally, physically, amen. Instead of giving God the glory, amen, for the state that you were in, you said, Lord God, this is my lot in life. Not so. Not so. Amen. God saying, I'd rather you be close to me. Amen. And sometimes, you know, when you're in a relationship, you get closer to some things don't go right. Amen. And you just got to put your head in and talk to them like, I don't know what happened. I really didn't want to be this way. It's called a heart change. A mind revelation. God said, I care about the relationship. God was the healing, forget about you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We declare, amen, right now that God, everything that you needed, God, amen, said is yours. Pastor, come with us, amen. But we come in here and touch you. Pastor, pray, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. We just want to touch hands and agree with these up here on the altar on today. As Pastor, amen, give us a word, amen. Because God is a yoke-breaking God. Regardless of how bad the situation is, we just want to touch and agree and walk, amen. Pastor, give us a word, amen, as he share with us, amen.
Amen. Amen. God loves expectancy. He loves the person that's waiting, that's expecting something. If you come in and you have something in your heart, something that you need God to do, put it at the front of your mind. Have an expectancy that God is going to meet that need. Have an expectancy that he's going to show up in your situation. That every trial you have will become a victorious situation. Without fight, there is no victory. So never mind the fight, but just know that God is on the way to prepare a victory for you. Just as he did with David, as Bishop was saying, in the midst of your situation, God will step in. God will give you what it needs to supersede through what's ahead of you. Before he had to face that giant, what David say? I faced a bear. There was a bear that came, and I laid hands on that. God had prepared him for what was getting ready to come. Everything you're facing right now, God has already prepared you for. He's already placed you in a position to where you can be victorious over your situation. He's only waiting for you to bring it. He says, my strength is made perfect in your weakness. You don't have to be able to handle it on your own. Just bring it to me and let me take it from you. My strength is made perfect in your weakness. Sometimes we feel like we need to handle it. We need to be able to get through it. We need to be able to make it over this hump. We need to be able to make it over this hill. But God has said, it's not in you to make it. It's in me for me to make it in you. You be you and me and allow me to be me and you. Allow me to bring you through this situation. That's all he's asking for. Every trial that's placed in front of you is something that's placed that it catapults you to your victory. God is not done with you yet. God is not done with you yet. Everything that's needed to be given, everything that's needed for you to be able to make it through, God has given it to you. He has not finished with you yet. No matter how the situation looks, whether it's bad, whether it looks ugly, God is saying to you today, if you have a pulse, you still have a purpose. If you woke up this morning with a pulse, you still have a purpose. I'm still using you. I'm still waiting to place you where I need you at. I just need you to continue to be faithful. Lord, so we ask that you keep us faithful. The word said it is you that is faithful, Lord. We ask that you keep us, that you maintain us, that you continue to be God over our situation, that you continue to be God in our life, that you continue to reign over us, that you continue to count us worthy as your people, that you continue to stay in this midst, that you continue to come into this building. Every week that we come in, every time that we come here, Lord, that you meet us here, that you meet us here, Lord. Because of your will that is in, we are able. All is possible. Lord, we put our faith in you. We put our trust in you. We put our ability in you. We put our situations in you. We put our circumstance in you. We put our prosperity in you. We put everything we have in you. Because of you is our trust, Lord. You are what we live for. You are what we live for. Whatever it is you need from God in this situation, in this atmosphere, he is waiting. He is waiting for you to come. He is waiting for you to put that burden on him. He says, follow me, my yoke is light. My yoke is light. It don't require much. It don't require much. A little bit of faith. A little bit of trust. A little bit of faith. A little bit of simple trust. Simply trust that I'm here. Encourage him, Lord. Build him. Strengthen him. Strengthen him. Strengthen him. Strengthen him, Lord. Pour back into him, Lord. Pour into him, Lord. Give it to him, Lord. So that he can give it out to us. Increase him. So that he can increase us. Because you can, Lord. The man that has given his heart unto you, give back unto him. Give it to him, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Listen, don't stop praising him. Keep saying, just say thank you. If it's done, but thank you, Lord, we love you. He just wants to hear it. Do the one thing for God that he can't do for himself. Praise him. Tell him, Lord, I love you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I know that you are here. For the things that you have already done, for the things that you are still to do, Lord, we trust in you. We love you. We believe in you. Lord, we love you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. A child that really needs something will cry out to their father consistently until they do. God is looking for the same thing. Don't give up. Just because I haven't moved yet, continue to cry out. Continue to cry out. The word says the heart of the king is in the hand of God. You never know the time it takes for him to move that person. Continue to cry out. Continue to tell him, Lord, I love you. Lord, I thank you. Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Soldiers. Steadfast. Yes. 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 Steady, dependable. Yes. A heart for you, God. Increase it, Lord. Increase it. Increase our capacity to understand, to be with them, to stay when times are hard, Lord, to have faith in a situation we can't see. Increase it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. By your mercy, by your grace, by your sufficiency, because you have given all the world. We continue to stand. We continue to ask for you. We continue to need you, to lead you to heal us, to need you to carry us, guide us. Yes. Let it be a step. Let it be a step. Every prayer, every word, every desire, every need, every want, let it be a step. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Because we know it's done. Yes. Let us, Father, let us continue in your ways. Let us continue to trust us. Let this man be in us. Let us be in us, Jesus. Yes. 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 Yes, God. We love you. Yes. Yes. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we give all of this to you. We give everything we have to you. We give all of these to all of you. Because we know that you're willing, that you're able, that you will, that you're willing, that you have. Increase sacrifice, increase. Because as you increase and you open up, more will be given. As you pour out, more is given. As you pour out, more is given in. Empty us. Everyone in this place should be empty today, Lord. The word said you can't use a full vessel. The prophet told it, as the vessels become full, set them to the side and get an empty one so that you can continue to pour in. So we empty ourselves in here today, Lord. We are empty. We are empty. We give all glory unto you. All praises unto you. Increase. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Yes. Because it's already done. It's already done. Yes. Yes. Freedom, Lord. Freedom. Freedom of thoughts. Yes. Lord, if you take away the clutter. If you take away the clutter, you serve. the way you are, so that our mind can be set on you. So our mind can be stayed on you, Lord. Yes. Lord, we thank you. 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 Father, we thank you. We thank you for what you've already done. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, we love you. Lord, we love you. Lord, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. 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 As you speak it, he will do it. As you speak it, he will do it. Yes. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes. Lord, thank you. Lord, thank you. Lord, we thank you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. 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 If you can believe it. Yes, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. Because he has. Yes. 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 Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes. Yes.
Concerning your situations, he's looking to step into that. If you can give it to him, if you can totally give it to him. Yes, Lord. Lord, we ask you that you continue to abide in this place. That you continue to touch every heart as they leave here. That you continue to minister to them as they go. That you continue to increase them, to increase their faith. Increase their faith in those things that they don't believe. Increase their faith in that area, Lord, so that they can increase it. We ask that you cover every person. You cover every heart, mind, and soul in this place. You block the enemy from having any contact with our spirit, with our mind. We give it all unto you. We leave nothing out, nothing available. We leave no room. No room for the enemy to come in, to creep in. We give no cause, we give no occasion. We give everything we have over to you. And we ask that you continue to carry us. You continue to cover us. You continue to increase us. You continue to bless us. You continue to be our God. You continue to guide us. And we continue to stay in you.
Amen.
God, amen. I thank you, Pastor. Amen. To do everything but faith. All you got to do is believe enough, amen, to walk with you where you don't see them, but God said there is something. Amen. Because when you do that, he said, because of your faith, Amen. As you step, everything you need is right there available. Amen. Just thank God, amen, for Pastor Keys on today. Amen. Such a powerful word. Amen. We've been here all week, amen. We just thank God, amen, that there are those, amen, that's going to continue to give what God said give. Amen. Right on time. We thank Hickory Grove, amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody give God
away from home.
Thank God for praying for Hickory Grove all the way from Kinston, North Carolina. Hallelujah. We're glad that you came. You did not have to do it, but we thank God that you did. Hallelujah.
And just keep rolling. Amen. Every time I turn around, see Hickory Grove, they're going to be there.
They're going to be there.
And we love our mothers. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Such a great God of passion. Grown mothers be supporting my uncle. I like it. Amen. They love him. Such a great man of God. Amen. We just thank God for him.
Amen.
In every capacity. Amen. We thank everybody that came out today on this morning. Amen. We thank God for our TFL emotion person. Amen. Amen. This fitness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. She done worked the ladies and all them out.
She'll work it.
Had them all sweating, all ready to fall and quit.
Be calling on the Lord. She'll definitely bring you closer to Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Calling on your help.
Jesus, I need some help with these push-ups.
Amen.
She's about to take me around the block. I don't want to go.
I ain't trying to die today.
But to God be the glory. We thank God for her. For not listening to us when we complaining. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Because it's the same way in the spirit realm. We thank God that he don't always listen to us complaining. And he'll take us anyway. So to God be the glory. God is awesome. We thank God for each and every one of you.
Thank the other Ash for presiding. She's been presiding all week. You've been keeping her busy.
Amen. Somebody give God a hand, have a praise.
That's a great job.
Not just Elder Sharon, but Elder Richard. Amen. He opens up with the praise team. Amen. We thank God for Elder Sharon.
It is tight.
Amen.
I tell you, the praise team, God has brought us a long way.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
God is able to do anything but fail. And that's what I love a lot about him. Amen. You just stick with God.
Amen.
Amen. That's what I said. Stick to it. Say amen. Wait. Yeah. Stick to it. You have some of that stuff, boy, I tell you. God, that's the. Yes, exactly. Exactly. See it?
You don't listen to him.
See, we there. You be listening to the word of the day.
Hallelujah. To God be the glory.
But amen. So we thank the man. Amen. And
amen.
Thank Hickory Grove,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes. We thank God for the word on today, the word all of this week.
Amen. The anointing makes the difference.
Amen.
Amen. Whatever it is, you know what? And you get the anointing, amen, by being in someone's presence. Amen. Relationship. Amen. You want to get the anointing of God on your life? Amen. Get into his presence.
Amen.
Spend some time. Amen. Then, you know, just like when you spend time with your significant other, they like, y'all be thinking alike. Y'all act like, y'all even starting to look alike.
Go ahead.
Y'all sure y'all ain't related. It's because you done spent so much time. Your genes don't even know what's right. They like, okay, we just start, you know, simulating. Start looking like each other, acting like each other.
Resistance is futile.
Resistance is futile. If y'all ain't a trekkie, you say, I love some Star Trek back in the day.
Hallelujah. God is everywhere.
Amen. So we just thank God for everyone, amen, that came out today to celebrate. Then the ushers, y'all bad because
we saw.
We work out of there. We getting out of doors.
We not used to us, so we just bumping in and then coming
like,
in and out. We apologize, but we thank God that you're here and you're still on post.
Right.
Hallelujah. Somebody gets, no matter how hard they be still, no matter how hard they criticize, lift up and stay on post. Hallelujah.
Yeah, I'm going to borrow that one.
I like it.
Amen. It's going to be a lot of ducking. That's what I was doing. I didn't know what it was. I was just like dodging, like.
Duck and weed.
Yeah. Every now and then it hits you, like, just keep right on rolling.
Amen.
Amen. We just thank God for you, amen. We do have some refreshments and some food for you, so you ain't got to go home hungry. We know it's been a long morning. Amen. And we know we love to eat. I know how it is. Amen. There was nothing else the brother came out just again. Pastor, uncle.
Amen.
Amen.
Uncle, aunt, minister, Belinda Keys.
Exactly. We just thank God for you. Amen. Yes, we work every year. Amen. Y'all ain't got tired of us yet. That's good. That's all right. I ain't seen nobody come in frowning yet, so like we still straight. I know how to say, okay, they tired of getting work. They tired of that travel. Amen. Well, we just thank God for you.
Again, we thank God for Sister Kiara and her dance today. Give God glory. It was awesome. Amen. To God be glory. That's what I like. She got that funk. Hallelujah. She like she was fighting off some devils. Hallelujah. You got to have that girl. Go ahead.
Amen.
To God be the glory. We thank God for her stepping out. Amen. Here at Truth for Life. We thank God for Truth for Life members. We thank God for all the hard work. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. It don't take a lot, but when you got the mind of Christ, amen, you can get a lot done. And so we thank God for each and every one of you, amen, that have helped us this week. To God be the glory.
Amen. We're going to have Pastor Keys come back and release us, amen, and pray over the food. Amen. Just thank God again. And yeah, it's been 3 years. We've been in ministry for 11 years. And like I said, which we understand. I didn't care if nobody talked about us anyway, so I mean, I just like put my ear to the wind. Because I know how it is, amen. I know we left, yeah, it was some words said. But God, amen. That's not about God. Like, I don't care what folks say about you. I don't care where they try to put you. If God ain't trying to hate it, it don't matter. So you don't need to spend your time and your attention worrying about folks. Pride. Mind trouble. Amen. Mind trouble. Amen. So we just thank God, amen, because when God has opened the door and put his stamp of approval, it ain't nothing man can do. Amen. Ain't nothing.
Come on, give God another hand clap of praise. Amen. We thank God for all that's been said and done this day. Give him all the glory and all the praise.
Yes.
For without him, we can do nothing. With this praise is holy man. Hickory Grove, I thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise God. Brother, you're still showing your love. Amen, amen. Praise God. Our hearts and minds are clear. Let us stand. We have a close and loud call. What our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard. Yes. We thank you for your spirit moving throughout the house, Lord. Yes. We give you glory and praise now. That unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think according to the power that worketh in us. Father, we ask you to bless the food that has been prepared. Let it be nourishment for our bodies, sanctified and purified. Bless the hands that prepared it. We love you, we praise you, we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Can we shout amen?
Amen.
Amen.